There's a fellow we all know at an Austin water hole. That's Johnny at the door. He takes your money and lets you in, and right away you make a friend of Johnny at the door. Nobody bothered asking Johnny what his last name was. He just said, "My name is Johnny," and that was good enough for us. He's the kind of guy you swear that you met somewhere before. Johnny at the door, that's right. Nobody really knows where he calls home except Johnny at the door. Well, I heard it said he had himself a tendency to roam. Oh, Johnny at the door. Nobody bothered asking Johnny what his last name was. He just said, "My name is Johnny. That was good enough for us. He's the kind of guy you swear you met somewhere before. Johnny at the door." Whose idea was that? So that's Don Pollock on the pedal steel, ladies, all the way from Austin, Texas. He actually is the only guy in the band. He's a millionaire. And I thought I'd tell that to you, ladies, because, well, I mean, practically, he owns his own home in Austin, Texas, therefore, you know. Therefore, he's a millionaire. That's how much his taxes are. I'm not there. And back on the drums, all the way from Del Rio, Texas, Manny Pagan. Oh, Manny Pagan. Before I got on stage here, somebody gave Don an envelope. Don thought it was some sort of special thing. Sounds of Texas. Oh, really? Really? That's how you're going to play this now? He hands it to me. It says, Sounds of Round Rock, Texas. And he goes, "I don't know what this is about." I go, "I think it's probably south of Round Rock, Texas request." Really? Does that mean you want to admit that? Who gave it to you, Doc? Has anybody asked? Who asked for that? It had a $100 bill in it. I want to make sure he does. South of Round Rock, one, two, three, two.
Quite a few. Well, thank you for coming back. Me and both of them did not raise their hand. So. That makes sense. Makes perfect sense. You see my last show. Reason I ask is I got a couple of new songs I'm going to be doing, and this is one I'm going to start off with here. Now I'm doing an acoustic album, recording that. We're playing at the Grand Ole Opry July 22nd. I'm amazed that you invite me back, and I'm blown away. I don't got what they call one of them things manager. I don't got a manager. I got a booking agent. So every now and then, I always expect the last time I played the Opry is going to be the last time I played the Opry. And so I'm very honored to be asked back over there. So yes, I wrote this new song. This is a song I think I'm going to do on that. Let's go ahead and do it like we've been doing it, fellas. Hopefully right. It's called I'm Amazed I Love You Less Than Just Yesterday. What? What? Well, everybody says I love you more today than yesterday. I'm amazed I love you less than yesterday. That's a compliment, by the way. Come on. I know you gotta think about it. I know. No, wait a minute, you're hearing it, stop, you're hearing it wrong. I didn't say less than yesterday. I said I loved you less just yesterday. See, you put that in there, I didn't put that in there. Yesterday. trucking Jerry Lee, it's all this stuff. So he takes them all out, drags that whole stand out to the parking lot, tips it over, and lights a cigar, and he goes to the bus, gets his lighter fluid out, sets it all on fire. He said, you know you're going to have to pay for that? He says, nope, no I do not. Have the guys who bootlegging my music pay for it. How did I get here? Oh yeah, truck stop McGrain. Just did not happen there.
Say, I learned from another guy about LaGrange.
He went out to that chicken ranch out there. He got them to shut it down because there was too much incentive for the football team. If they won, they'd get a trip out to the chicken ranch. That's right. It was Marvin Zindler. That might be a record if that many people do that. And he shut down the chicken ranch because of slime. That is a record.
Hell.
baby.
Try Wendy. Most of all, Yellow Lessicado, it's flat. It is so flat. For 100 miles, and it's just any direction, anywhere. But if you stand on a dime, you can see for 200 miles. So flat that you still want to stand on a nickel, you can see for 400 miles. So flat. Got out the bus one day, just kind of look around, look down the street. Telescope, one of the binoculars of Don Gary's, and I can see the back of my head. So flat that David Buxcomer's dog ran away about a month ago. He's all sad about it. I talked to him, thought he was sad because of the drought, because it's been a month. He said, no, I'm still sad because every time I go out my back door, I can still see my dog running away. Guys don't understand this one. I'll tell you this. Have you ever seen them? They're levelers, you know. Ladies, you know what a leveler is. It's got that little bubble in it. You know how when you say your husband's a half a bubble off? They use that thing. Leveler. Well, guess what? Last time I was up there, I seen a whole convention. That's where they go to put the bubble in and make it level. So flat. That's where they go to do it.
And Yellow Lessicado. She took on love. Fox on the run. Hey, like a fox.
Ladies, I hate to be the one to tell you this, but there's men get, after a while, they kind of tune out. Our frequency. Oh, really? Yeah, man, my stepdad was great at that, man. He was great. My mom, when she would, I'm not gonna say she nagged. She wasn't a nagger. She was more of a, just a. You'd think she was talking to herself the entire day. She was going, oh, why you boys got to leave these socks around? But just don't have them down that much. I feel like I'm your housekeeper. But Indian, the way you grew up in Indian Village, this is. But she would do this to my stepdad, and so whenever she'd be talking to him, he didn't know it. He was talking all day long. He just kind of tuned her out. So, and then something come out and said, Don, that's my stepdad. Don, do you hear what I said? Yeah. No, I hear you, honey. I've learned to tune in to the women's. What song do you want to hear alive in that dream? Dude, come on, dude. Love song that I wrote.
dentist's office while I was getting my teeth cleaned.
Yeah.
It took a long time for it to do that. I'm not talking about my hygiene. I got brush, I floss. I floss at least twice a year. I hate flossing, I really do.
No, but I was
in a dentist's office, and I was there in the front office, like a waiting, just reading a magazine, and in that magazine, happened to be a page that said, things heard backstage at the CMAs. CMAs just happened, but I didn't care, because I quit listening to CMAs when they stopped doing country music. There I was, sitting there, and I was the only one in the office, just waiting and eating a box of Oreo cookies like I always do when I go to the dentist's office. Well, how are you going to know if your teeth are clean, man? Pretty clean. If I walk out of there and ain't no... I knew he did a good job. There I was. And sure enough, it said, things heard backstage at the CMAs, and it had a picture of Waylon Jennings and Merle Haggard. The problem is it didn't attribute who said what to who, but it did say somebody came by, one of the stagehands came by in a CMA shirt. He said, and a hat. And so one of them said to the other one, to CMA. It should stand for Country My Ass. I'm gonna write that song. My ass. I want to record that song. I said, I'll be honored. He says, and
He said, well, my wife thinks that people might not like me cussing. You know, I've done all my career and haven't cussed, but I feel like I need to shake them up a bit. I said, all right, I hope you do. And he was playing on the recording.
I think it was an assassination.
You know what's funny, if I'd have mentioned that in say, I don't know, 2015, it would have sounded really crazy. Yeah. Yeah. But these days, it's not far-fetched. It's really, really not. I mean, Jesus, what's going on today, man? It's a light stuff. But I think he was murdered. Because somebody knew he was going to do my song. He would change everything. But I always hear George Jones' voice in this last verse. I'll give you some of that steel guitar. Give me some of that George Jones steel. Kid D, though.
Well, I feel her spell.
grown man cry. She can make a man sit down, shut up, dig a bone right in front of his eyes. She was my baby.
Pine Curtain, behind the Pine Curtain. And really like it a lot up here. And right next to the train station. I love taking the train. And but I didn't know until I moved there that it was the birthplace of the Boogie Boogie. So, yeah. I mean, I wrote a song about 59, I love 59, and Texas Boogie and all that. But I had no idea that Marshall, that area was the birthplace of the Boogie Woogie. So a friend of mine who he owns a great restaurant up there right near the railroad track, remember, the depot there called the Ginocchio. It's a great restaurant. If you're ever up in Marshall, go to that place. Again, if you take the train and you get off, it's right there. But I think me and him are going to put together a Boogie Woogie Festival at some point. I think we're aiming for late fall of 23. So, yeah, it's going to be a fun little deal. Have some folks up there that know about the Boogie Woogie music, like Sleepy Will. We're trying to get them. Yeah. But I wrote a song called Marshall Boogie. Apparently, there's different kinds of boogies depending on the town that these musicians at the time would play to the trains that were coming in. They'd make up rhythms with that train rhythm, and this was the Marshall Boogie. That's what it's known as. Musicians would tell the other musician, play a Marshall Boogie. Oh yeah. There it was, born right here in Texas. Boogie Woogie. You know what, you got your Boogie Woogie, you know it. It's in you. It's in you. It's got to come out. That's right. Texas in you.
Apologize to the other nuts out there.
just my experience. So yeah, I've messed for a while, but at the time I didn't think it was, and I kept doubting if I had my sanity. So the definition of insanity, they say, is doing the same thing over and over and getting a different result. So this song actually I wrote because this girl I was seeing at the time, and she said, "Yeah, I want to let's make this a regular thing." She said, "You're not very good at this." He says, "Well, you've been married 4 times. No. That's insane." No. Okay. No argument there. See if I can remember the song. Here we go.
Thank you.
Norway Mawson. Don Pollock and Bill Stevens. sure enough, we'd save them, bringing us stuff to say. Sounds so good, I want to do it. I've had plenty of bowls. I've had plenty of bowls of bald peanuts. And I've had some shrimp gumbo, but I've never had a cooler full of boudin. Now that I wrote in the song, I just got to do it. That's a lot of boudin. I can do it. Man, I want to make sure that somebody, and holler a song you came to hear. Karen, we already did it. First song we did. How are you?
Loose step behind me.
Stop. Stop. I got it now. Well, I gotta be honest. I did get a nice bowl of cookies, homemade oatmeal cookies. So, what is you want here? Daughter's wedding song, all right? That's very different from your cooler full of boudin. You see, boys. It was pretty cool that Dwayne Johnson, The Rock, he posted this on his Instagram that it wasn't his favorite song. He didn't say that. He said, this is his daughter's favorite song, which is even cooler, really.
Thank you. looking at that.
That's what it is. Starve in your box, that's what it is.
Glad to come out and talk to y'all and sign anything. Thank you again for coming.